Greetings, friends. My name is Peter, and this is the Retro Unscripted series. As always, I thank you for watching, for subscribing, for liking, all of that stuff. When you do that, it certainly indicates that you like the work and that no greater compliment can be had. So I really do appreciate that. I know I'm a bit late with this week's episode. I apologize. I am still dealing with track and field arm. It's been a couple of weeks now, and I'm still very sore, so I haven't done a lot of gaming, I haven't done a lot of writing. I've been trying to nurse my arm back to health. It's been a bit humbling for sure, because my right arm is my dominant arm, so I've been doing a lot of stuff left-handed, and I'll tell you, I am not ambidextrous at all, so it's been a little rough. But here I am in front of you guys, and I'm ready to talk to you today, and I want to thank Pat the NES Punk for inspiring this particular episode, because he's actually celebrating the 5th anniversary of his Flea Market Madness series. He just posted today his latest installment of Flea Market Madness and made a mention that it's been 5 years. And it just so happens that the Flea Market Madness series has a lot to do with the retro revival that I've been going through for the last 2+ years, honestly. He has a lot to do with that, and I'll explain right now. Flashing back to 2010 and 2011, if you're familiar with my work on my consolation blog or how I post on Twitter, you probably noticed that during that time, I became a pretty cynical individual. There were a lot of things going on in modern gaming that were really personally ticking me off. And I know that you don't take that stuff personally, but there were changes that were going on that I really wasn't liking as a video game consumer. I was not a fan of DLC. I was not a fan of retailer exclusive pre-order stuff like we saw in L.A. Noire. I wasn't a fan of this new multiplayer explosion where everything seemed to be multiplayer and single player seemed to be falling by the wayside. And there were just things that were piling up that were making me not a happy video game player. So as I moved through 2011, I began to collect PlayStation 2 games. I started to go backwards just a little bit. PlayStation 2 games were starting to become a bit cheaper. I actually purchased a brand new PS2, which unfortunately is already starting to fail on me a little bit, but I bought that, and I bought some games that were starting to come down in price, and I started to build a pretty good collection. In fact, by the end of 2011, I was into triple digits as far as my PS2 game collection was. Now, I was still playing PlayStation 3 and Xbox 360 games, and of course, I was still part of the gaming press at that point, so that was still a very big part of my life, but I found that playing older games started to kind of quell that cynicism a little bit and make me a little less grumpy. So when I moved from Arizona back to Massachusetts in late 2011, and as 2012 got underway, I started to really question what it was that I wanted to do in terms of how I spent my time playing video games. I knew that the next generation of video game systems was going to be coming. There wasn't a question about that. It had been, wow, at that point it had been 6 to 7 years since the video game systems for Generation 7 had arrived. So I kind of asked myself, am I going to just buy those systems because that's the next big thing? Or am I just going to stick with my PS2? Or what is it that I'm going to do? And at this time, in March of 2012, after purchasing a Super Nintendo Entertainment System from my cousin Sam, things began to change. And one of the reasons for that is because Sam mentioned something about Pat the NES Punk and a series of videos called Flea Market Madness. So I went home, I looked up Pat, I found his Flea Market Madness videos on Retroware TV, and I started to watch. And I instantly fell in love with the series. It was the thrill of the hunt. It was finding games that I hadn't played or seen in a long time. It was about Pat's passion and his knowledge and just having fun with it. And it really kind of shook something loose inside me and kind of was a personal awakening. Video games are supposed to be fun. They're not supposed to be things that we constantly complain and get upset about. And there are games that exist that tend to not make me angry or upset. And that's really what you see on the shelving unit behind me and in the rest of my collection. Over the last 2+ years, I've gradually, as best as I possibly can, built up a collection of Nintendo, Super Nintendo, Genesis, Sega CD games, so on and so forth, so that I have things to look forward to for not only now, but also for the foreseeable future. And it's not cynical. I can be a little cynical at times, especially if I wind up buying a game that I didn't research first and realize that it was a pretty bad investment, but or if it's just a really bad game. But, you know, I'm not that angry guy as much anymore. And in fact, my passion level has skyrocketed since when it comes to retro gaming and being part of the retro community. While I'm not one of the bigger personalities by a long shot, what I've found to be really touching is that a lot of the really big, really recognizable retro gaming personalities have really been down to earth. And when I've reached out to them, when I've talked to them on Twitter or on their YouTube channels, it's been like I'm part of the family. Even this small operation that is Retro Unscripted, they like it. They think that it's a really neat thing that I'm doing. And not only that, but we share the same passion. We share the same enthusiasm. When one of us finds, when somebody in the community finds a really good deal on an NES game that usually costs $25 or $30, we cheer. We sometimes look with envy on other people's collections, but at the same time, it's really neat because people are still able to find these things out in the wild and play them. And there are a lot of people that actually do buy the games and with the purpose of playing them, not just to put them on any kind of pedestal. And I think that that's fantastic. So really, the whole retro revival, which I've enjoyed, which now writing for RetroWare TV is a big deal to me personally, because that's the site that really kind of helped me cross over and get in touch with the gamer inside that I wanted to be. So with Pat celebrating the 5th anniversary of Flea Market Madness this month, I want to send a note of thanks and appreciation not only to Pat and to Frank and what they do, but to the rest of the retro community, to all of you guys. It's you that really inspires me to do what I do. It's you that gives me that springboard, that soundboard, to be able to talk about my memories and my experiences. And you're interested in that stuff. It's not stuff that's just kind of out there and is a dime a dozen. Everyone has their own individual story, their own unique story, their own unique experience. And that's, you can't replace that. That's not something that you can have 8 different websites writing about the same thing. That's when I played Super Mario Brothers for the first time versus when Joe Walker might have played Super Mario Brothers for the first time, or when, almost anybody. I mean, all of our experiences change. And that's really what motivates me, what drives me. I'm grateful to be part of the RetroWare family, and I'm very, very grateful to be part of the retro community as it stands. And if it wasn't for my cousin Sam, and it wasn't for Pat and his work, which I have enjoyed for the last 2+ years, who knows what I'd be doing now. So thanks, Pat. Thanks, Sam. And thanks to all of you in the retro community for being the motivators and the inspirational community that you are. As always, I thank you for watching Retro Unscripted. Again, it's now on my personal channel, which is youtube.com/GameGuyPeter, and I'll make sure that I post the address below for you. If you have comments, please feel free to leave them below. Also, my latest RetroWare article just recently went up, talking about being on the retail side of selling Superman 64 and the interesting experience that was, and how even to this day I haven't been able to bring myself to play it despite selling it to everybody. So I hope that you'll find that article interesting as well. Until next week, I thank you for watching Retro Unscripted, and I will see you next time. Until then, take care.